as much as you like, my dear. No one can hear you here.
Why have you strapped me to this operating table?
Call it an old man's whim.
All right, why have you strapped me to this old man's whim? And what? What? And what are you doing with that little black box?
Don't worry, my dear, you won't feel a thing. I'll just attach a wire here, a wire there, and then I turn this knob and...
This is the BBC. Ladies and gentlemen, it's around the hall.
No, no! Anything but that!
Yes, it's round the horn. This is the witching hour, the time that ghoulies and ghosties and long-legged beasties walk abroad.
And they're not bad judges, because here is Kenneth Horne.
Hello and welcome to the show. Well, now, as this is the first of the series, here are the answers to last week's questions. Complete the following similes, and the answers were as a brush, like the clappers, and as a coot. Now, I got several correct answers and a letter from a firm of solicitors threatening legal proceedings and representing a Mr. A. Coot. Apparently, it's quite untrue, as he was at home in bed at the time, and he sent a photograph to prove it, taken at home. In bed, at the time. Right now, Smith.
Armpit Theatre presents a gripping story of German air aces in World War I. Cheaper than the Blue Max, Armpit Theatre presents the Plastic Max.
My name is Heinrich von Horstwessel und Klagenfurst, Reichstiefelsamund, Platzervogel, Stumpenrock, und Gildenplatzer. There's a hyphen in it somewhere, but I never can find it. Now, the year was 1918, and I was the commandant of a German fighter squadron on the Western Front. The war was going badly. Our planes were in a shocking state, and we were sending up anything that could fly, patched up albatrosses, clapped out halberstadts, and we even tied wings on the squadron goat. But you can't do the things with a goat you can do with a Sopwith camel. And if the planes were bad, the pilots were worse, with no experience of combat. One morning, there was a knock on my office door. Come in.
Oberleit in the Grasspiegel reporting, sir.
As you were.
As I was what, sir?
As you were when I first met you. The moonlight gleaming through your sauerkraut.
A new batch of pilots has arrived.
Ask them to goose-step this way.
In here, pig dogs. Eins, zwei, eins, zwei, und!
Grossbagel, call the roll.
Yes, sir. Von Schicksal.
Yup.
Adolf Steiglitz.
Yup.
Albrecht von Gotha-Dammerung.
Yup.
Cohen.
Hello.
I'm a little bit worried about Cohen.
Oh. Why, sir?
He's the new chaplain.
Hans Pertwangler.
Your roll, mein Kapitän. That's your actual German.
Who was this young Furtwängler who stood before me? He was a different cut, of a different cut to the others. The others all had dueling scars on their cheeks. He had one down his back. Tall, blonde, arrogant, handsome almost to a fault.
Go on, does my heart good to hear it.
Well, that's all there is.
That's all there is?
Yeah.
And anything about my appealing elfin face, my doe-like orbs, my fashionably flat figure, my coltish legs. Isn't there anything about that?
Well, they must have forgotten to put it in.
I could have been another Twiggy.
Too late, you were twigged long ago, Charlie. May we continue?
Oh, don't let me stop you, Jackie.
Right.
Sorry, I'm sure.
Furtwängler. Furtwängler, you're looking at me strangely.
Yes, sir. It's those medals you're wearing. What are they?
Well, this one is the Kaiser's medal for conspicuously helping old ladies across the Unter den Linden. And this one is my Yogi Bear Club badge and bar. And this is Germany's highest award, the plastic max.
Oh, I should like to wear the plastic max.
You have to be an ace to win the max like Captain Horse von Cockpowder.
Is he stationed here?
Yes, see that tiny speck up there?
Yes.
Well, wipe it off, will you? It's those damn flies. They get everywhere. But here he is coming into land now. That's von Cockpowder, the greatest ace in Germany.
Oh, what a pilot. He can make that plane do anything.
See the way he's weaving his way through that herd of cows on the runway. And look at that.
A perfect pancake landing. Cook.
Jawohl.
We'll be having sliced beef for dinner.
The mess. Some hours later. The pilots are discussing their day's adventures.
And there I was, just north of Mons, and I saw this dogfight. I climbed, banked, and threw a bucket of water over them.
I hear the English are using tiger moths. How can we combat them?
We're being issued with tiger mothballs.
I didn't know tiger moths had...
Waiter!
...had been invented yet.
Yes, sir. More beer, sir?
Yes, bring us two steins.
Here you are, sir.
I'm Epstein.
I'm Goldstein.
Boy, are we in the wrong plot.
I think the Americans have entered the war.
Why do you say that?
I nearly shot down Ben Lyon today.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, Furtwängler.
Is that von Cockpowder over there, the one with the window in his eye?
That's a monocle, yes.
Oh, yeah.
I'll introduce you. Von Cockpowder, yeah. I'd like to present, in association with S.A. Gorlinski, Hans Furtwängler.
Pleased to meet you, Cockpowder.
Not plain Cockpowder. Can't you tell by the way I stand, the way I move, the way I hold a cigarette, that I am a von?
You can't blame him. It takes von to recognize another. He's a commoner.
And they don't come much commoner than him.
You Junkers are all the same. You're also proud because you wear the plastic max. But I'll win the max myself one day. I'll shoot down more planes than you. Then it'll be Junkers go home.
The aristocrat air ace smiled icily, bowed, clicked his dentures, turned, and goose-stepped out of the mess. But fate had not finished its grim gavotte. The tragedy lurked in the wings. Enter Betty Marsden, all eyes and teeth, many of them her own.
Ach, darling, ever so lonely without you. How about a little drinky for your liebling?
Oh, Hans, this is my wife, Brunhilde. Brunhilde, Hans Furtwängler.
Come here, woman. Kiss me.
But my husband.
Damn your husband. I love you.
Oh, darling, darling. I love you too.
Run away with me. Be mine.
Yes, yes, my darling. Yes, yes. Yours. I'll be yours forever.
Oh, good. For a moment, I thought you two mightn't get on.
The next day, preparing for the dawn patrol.
Well, this will be your plane, Furtwängler.
What is it?
It's a Douglas Smith Mark II. Now, just try the throttle.
Rum, rum, fut, fut, cuss, plot. I need turning over.
That is the understatement of the year.
You can't send a boy like me up in a crate like him.
You've got to go. There's only you and von Cockpowder left. You're to keep in touch with each other by means of this. Now, this is the latest example of German technological electronic know-how.
What is it?
Two old baked bean tins attached by a length of cotton. Are you ready, von Cockpowder?
Jawohl, Herr Kommandant.
Good. The two pilots climbed into their machines, the mechanics swung the propellers, the planes taxied up the runway, and Furtwängler and von Cockpowder took off looking like two great birds.
It's a disgrace.
Red Leader to Red Fox 2, are you receiving me?
Red Fox 2 to Red Leader. I am receiving you loud and clear. I am flying at 5,000 feet over Cologne. Oh.
We hope you enjoyed this preview.
To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.